Welcome to a lesson on multiplying whole numbers. In this lesson, we'll discuss an alternative method for multiplying whole numbers, which we'll call the rectangular method, because determining the product is based upon determining the area of rectangles. So let's begin by reviewing the area formula for a rectangle. The area of a rectangle is equal to length times width. So for example, if we have a rectangle with a length of 2 meters and a width of, let's say, 6 meters, then the area of the rectangle is equal to 2 meters times 6 meters, which would be 12 square meters. And we can actually model this if we divide the length into two equal pieces here, and then divide the width into six equal pieces. So we'll first divide it into thirds, so we'll divide it here and here, then divide each third in half. So we divide it here, here, and here. Notice how we can see the 12 square meters inside the rectangle that's 2 meters by 6 meters. So now using this idea, we can determine the product of 53 and 37 by determining the area of this rectangle here, which consists of 4 smaller rectangles. So if we assume this length here is 53 units, because we have a 5 in the tens place value, we'll label this longer length 50. And because we have a 3 in the ones place value, we'll label the shorter length 3. Notice how the total length is still 53 units. And then we'll assume this is 37 units. So because we have a 3 in the tens place value, we'll put a 30 here and then a 7 here because we have a 7 in the ones place value. So now if we find the area of these 4 rectangles, we can determine the product of these 2 whole numbers. Let's start here. Notice how the dimensions are 3 by 7. 3 times 7 is 21, so the area would be 21 square units. Next, let's find the area of this rectangle here. Notice how it would be 50 by 7. 50 times 7 is 350. Let's go back down over here. This rectangle is a 3 by 30 rectangle. 3 times 30 is 90. And then finally, this larger rectangle here is 50 by 30. 50 times 30 is 1,500. So now if we find the sum of these 4 areas, we can find the product of our whole numbers. So we had 21 plus 350 plus 90 plus 1,500. So we have a 1 in the ones place value, and we have 16 in the tens place value. So we'll have a 6 in the tens place value, carry a 1 to the hundredths. We have a 9 in the hundreds place value and a 1 in the thousands place value. So our product is 1,961. Now after we do this a while, we can probably stop drawing this rectangle and find the product in the same way that we normally do, writing 53 times 37, as long as we pay close attention to the place value of each digit. So for example, we start with 7 times 3, that's 21. Because they're both in the ones place value. But then we multiply the 7 and the 5, that's 35. But since the 5 is in the tens place value, this is really 7 times 50, which gives us 350. Next, multiplying the 2 threes, this is really 30 times 3, which is equal to 90. And then finally, multiplying the 3 and the 5, that's really 30 times 50 because of the place value, which would be 1,500. And what we'll notice is, of course, this product is the same as this product here, which is 1,961. Let's go ahead and try another one of these. Here we have 49 times 35. So for this length here, we'll label the longer length 40 and the shorter length 9. And then for this length here, which we'll assume is 35, we'll label this length 30 and this length 5. And now we'll find the area of the 4 rectangles and then find the sum. So this rectangle here would be 9 by 5. 9 times 5 is 45. This rectangle here is 40 by 5. Well, 40 times 5 is 200. This rectangle here is 9 by 30. 9 times 30 is 270. And finally, for this rectangle here, we'd have 40 times 30, which is 1,200. And now we'll find the sum to find this product. So we had 45 plus 200 plus 270 plus 1,200. So we have a 5 in the ones place value, 11 in the tens, so we'll have a 1 here and carry 1 to the hundredths. We have 7 in the hundreds place value and a 1 in the thousands place value. So our product is 1,715. Or we can also set this up more traditionally as 49 times 35 and then multiply, paying attention to the place values. So 9 times 5, they're both in the ones place value, that's 45. Next we'd have 5 times 40 because the 4 is in the tens place value. 5 times 40 is 200. Next, this would be 30 times 9 since the 3 is in the tens place value. 30 times 9 is 270. And then finally we'd have 30 times 40 since they're both in the tens place value. 30 times 40 is 1,200. We can go ahead and add this up. It's the same sum as we have here in red. So we have 1,715 for our product. Let's go ahead and try one more example where we don't use the rectangle and just use the more traditional setup, multiplying each digit, paying attention to the place value. So here we have 286 times 64. So we'll start by multiplying the 4 and the 6, which are in the ones place value. So 4 times 6 is 24. Next we'd have 4 times 80, because the 8 is in the tens place value. 4 times 80 is 320. Next we'd have 4 times 200, because the 2 is in the hundreds place value. 4 times 200 is 800. And now we'll move to the 6, which is in the tens place value. So the first product is 60 times 6, which is 360. Next we have 60 times 80, because the 8 is in the tens place value. That would be 4,800. And then finally we have 60 times 200, because the 2 is in the hundreds place value. 60 times 200 is 12,000. And now we can add these to find the product. So we have a 4 in the ones place value, 2, 4, 10 in the tens place value. So we'll have a 0 in the tens place value and carry a 1 to the hundreds place value. So we have 4 plus 8, that's 12, plus 3 is 15, plus 8 is 23. We have a 3 in the hundreds, carry a 2 to the thousands. 2, 6, 8, we have an 8 in the thousands place value, and a 1 in the 10,000s place value. So our product is 18,304. I hope you found this explanation helpful.